Okay, last time we were doing the chapter optics. Now the optics is in the second semester. I think you are aware of it now. The exams will be held in the form of two semesters. First semester is in November and the second semester somewhere in
March, April.
March, April or February or March. That they will notify later. Okay. Little bit was left over in the telescopes. I just want to finish that. I don't think it will take much time. And then we will start magnetism. Okay. Magnetism is there in the first semester. Okay. Magnetism portion till alternating current is a bit lengthy. So, and for that, you need to concentrate very well. So, let us do today some portions of this one now. Telescopes. Okay. Right question. That's question from telescope. The objective and eyepiece of a telescope. The objective and eyepiece of a telescope have focal length 100 cm and 5 cm, 100 cm and 5 cm respectively. 100 cm and 5 cm respectively. Stop. Find the magnifying power of the telescope. Find the magnifying power of the telescope. And the length of the telescopic tube and the length of the telescopic tube. This question is quite simple and we'll do that. Magnifying power of telescope formula, we got this FO by FE. This is the formula. So we have the answer. FO is given 100. F is given 5, turns is 20. We can add 20x, magnifying power 20. If you just add 20 also is okay, acceptable. Magnifying power is okay. Alright, length of telescopic tube is same as the length of telescope. The formula will have FO plus FE. FO value is 100 and FE is 5, so answer is 105 cm. That is it. This question may carry 2 marks. 1 mark for this, 1 mark for this. That is it. Okay, now another question. Okay, right. The length of an astronomical telescope. Of magnifying power 19x 19. Magnifying power 20x is like 20x is 120 centimeters. Find the focal length of the objective and eyepiece. Find the focal length of the objective and the eyepiece. So this is the question. How we do? Magnifying power is given 20x. And the given length of the telescope is given 120 cm. Magnifying power formula that FO by FE is equal to 20. We can make the subject FO is coming 20 FE. Marking equation 1. FO value is 20 times of FE. Length of the telescope is FO plus FE. You can write here FO plus FE is equal to 120. I put the value of FO. 20 FE plus FE is equal to 120. If 21 FE is coming 120, therefore FE value is coming 120 by 21. You can divide and find also. 120 by 21, the answer comes how much? 5.714 centimeters. The value of FE I put in any of the equation, you find FO. Therefore, FO value is coming 20 times from this, 20 times from this answer. Or I can do here also, I will put the value here, 120 minus this I will do, and I will get the remaining answer. How much? 114.28 centimeters. That is the answer. Okay, simple question. Okay, one more question.
Right.
The focal length of objective and eyepiece. The focal length of objective and eyepiece. The focal length of objective and eyepiece of an astronomical telescope. Of an astronomical telescope. Are 100 centimeter and 5 centimeter respectively. 100 centimeter and 5 centimeter respectively. The final image is formed. The final image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision. The final image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision. Distinct vision. Find number one, magnifying power of the telescope. First one, magnifying power of the telescope. And number two, length of the telescope. Okay. Let us do this question. The question says FO, write down information. FO is given 100 centimeter. FE is given 5 centimeter. And question says the final image is forming at the least distance of distinct vision. That time the magnifying power formula will be FO by X. FO divided by X. Normal case, for normal use the formula is FO by FE. That is when the image, final image is forming at infinity. That is the normal case. When they don't mention anything, that is the normal case. So we do FO by FE, direct formula, which is previous one. But here it is mentioned the final image is forming at the least distance of distinct vision. So that FO by X, we calculate X value. X value is not given. To write the formula like this, 1 by X is equal to 1 by FE plus 1 by B. Write this formula. Get X. And after finding value of X, we put it here and find out the magnifying power. You can add 1 by X, 1 by FE is 1 by 5, this is 1 by 25. Get the answer here. 25 is the LCM. You get 5 plus 1, 6 by 25, therefore X value is coming 25 by 6, 4.17 centimeters. Therefore, magnifying power now. Therefore, M equal to FO, FO value is 100, and X value is, you can put 25 by 6 or 4.17. I like 25 by 6, easy to calculate. This 6 will come up, answer is coming 24. 24x. 25, 4 times will go. 6 will come up. 6 into 4 is coming 24. So magnifying power is 24x. Now find the length of the telescope. Therefore, length of telescope equal to FO plus X. FO is 100 and X value is 4.17. Answer is 104.17. So that is it. These are the types of problem on telescopes. Finished, huh? So in the chapter, in the optics, we have done till re-optics. All re-optics things portion is completed. Later on, once for the second semester, we can start from the wave optics. But now we are starting magnetism, okay? Magnetism, there are chapters, different chapters are there. But we will do in the chronological order, okay? We will do the topics which is needed first, that topic we will do first, and then we proceed. And then ultimately we have to do entire thing, whatever is there in the syllabus.
Yes, sir.
So first topic you need to write on, moving charges in magnetic field. In magnetic field. We will start with this topic, magnetism. Chapter topics, we are starting from this topic, or rather this chapter. We proceed slowly, okay, one by one.
Yes, sir.
Moving charges in a magnetic field, now write on below it, right? When a charged particle enters a magnetic field region, magnetic field region, comma, it experiences a magnetic force called Lorentz force, L-O-R-E-N-T-Z, Lorentz force, called Lorentz force. Lorentz force. To stop. The direction of this force, same end. The direction of this force is determined. The direction of this force is determined by Fleming's left hand rule. Fleming's, F-L-E-M-I-N-G apostrophe S. Fleming's left hand rule and its magnitude is given by. Write out the formula. F is equal to, we write that is Q V B sin theta. Its magnitude is given by the equation F is equal to Q V B sin theta. Right here, where Q is equal to amount of charge. Q is the amount of charge. V is velocity of the charged particle. B is magnetic field measured in terms of Tesla. Tesla is the A sign of magnetic field, you know, the high capability. Tesla. And theta is the angle between V vector and between V and B, magnetic field vector. Theta is the angle between velocity, direction of velocity, and the direction of magnetic field. Okay. Now write down below it. Lorentz force in vector form. Lorentz force in vector form. Okay, we write down Lorentz force in the vector form. Let's say F equal to Q bracket V cross B. in vector notation or in vector form, the Eure's force is written by this equation. F is equal to Q bracket V cross B, because theta cross product will be expressing the sine of the angle between these two vectors, sine of the angle. So Q bracket V cross B. This is quite an important question for 1 mark. They have asked almost 3-4 times in ISC. Express Lorentz force in vector form. We will just write this equation. F is equal to Q bracket V cross B. This equation is also known as vector defining equation. Write down here, vector defining equation of magnetic field. Vector defining equation of magnetic field. Give the vector defining equation of magnetic field, this one only. And this equation we use to define 1 Tesla. We'll find the definition of 1 Tesla by this equation. Okay. You can write down below. Definition of 1 Tesla. Tesla is the unit of magnetic field. Means how to define 1 Tesla of the magnetic field, or to define it. Okay. First, let me tell you the definition and the trick applied to define, okay? And then I put them into sentence. And the idea is like this. I take the value of B, we want to come 1, exactly 1. What I will do for that? I'll take the charge 1 coulomb. I'll take the velocity 1 meter per second. And I'll take the angle theta 90 degree. Sine 90 degree is 1. 1 into 1 into 1, you get B. B equal to F. That is magnetic field. 1 Tesla is that kind of force when the charge on the particle is 1 coulomb and the particle is moving with a velocity of 1 meter per second at an angle of 90 degree in a magnetic field region. So all these things we are framing into sentence. Understood the trick? Q value I take 1 coulomb, V value I take 1, theta value 90, then you will find B will be equal to F, and all the values 1 into 1 into sine 90 is also 1. B will be equal to F. So now the definition will become. Now all these things which I said, I will be framing a sentence, a good sentence out of it. Okay, right on. 1 Tesla is the magnetic field. 1 Tesla is the magnetic field. On 1 coulomb charge, on 1 coulomb, 1 C, you can write 1 capital, 1 coulomb charge moving normally with a velocity of 1 meter per second, with a velocity of 1 meter per second to the field which causes it to experience a magnetic force of 1 Newton, which causes it to experience a magnetic force of 1 Newton, 1 N, 1 capital N, magnetic force of 1 N, capital N. You can repeat it, what you have written, and just try to mean it, just try to understand, everything is being covered around what I say. Please check. 1 Tesla is the magnetic field on 1 coulomb, that is Q value of taking 1 coulomb charge, moving with a velocity 1 meter per second, normally means, you know, perpendicular, that is theta value 90 degrees, to the field, and which causes the particle to experience a force of 1 Newton. Then only the value of B will come 1, everything should be 1. Q1, V1, theta 90 degree, F should also 1, then V value will come 1 Tesla exactly. So this is how we find the definition. Though the idea I gave you, you can frame the sentence, you can change your sentence here and there, but all these things have to be covered. Okay. Now write down below that special cases. Below that special cases. Special cases. Number one. That when theta equal to 0 degree. When theta equal to 0 degree. First case we got when theta equal to 0 degree. Therefore, what will the answer coming here? F value will come here. Q V B sine 0. Sine 0 degree 0, the entire thing becomes 0. So under this case, what will happen? The charge particle will not experience any force. Force experienced on the charge particle will be 0. That means charge particle motion will be undeviated, will not get deviated there. Just like thus the charge particle will pass the magnetic field region, pass the magnetic field region undeviated. And the locus of its path is a straight line. That means the charged particle's motion will be undeviated. It will continue moving in the same direction with the same velocity. No change in the direction also. Okay, now case 2. Here we can just modify. You can write first case, no, right? When theta equal to 0 or just like this, or theta is equal to 180 degree. In both the cases, the charged particle will pass the region undeviated. Just you can add the angle 180 degree also. When theta is either 0 degree or 180 degree. Because sine 0 is also 0, sine 180 is also 0. Then the charged particle will go the magnetic field undeviated. It will not get any deflection there. Nothing will happen. It will continue moving with the same velocity. And the locus of its path will be straight line. Locus means the type of figure form. The type of figure form by its motion will be a straight line. Because it's not getting deviated. That is that. Now case 2. Case 1 I mean, now case 2. This is the important case. The second case is the most important. Right now, then theta equal to 90 degree. When theta equal to 90 degree, let us see what is happening. F is equal to Q V B sine 90, I will write here. Sine 90. Sine 90 is 1, therefore F value will become Q V B. Then its force will become maximum. There will be F max because theta value is 90 degree. Sine 90 degree is maximum, no, 1. So F max value will be coming here Q V B. This time the charge particle will experience a force. And due to that force, what will happen? There will be deviation produced in the path of the particle. The particle will get deviated. No? The particle will be having some other kind of motion. Right on. When a charged particle, below this slide, when a charged particle experiences, when a charged particle enters a magnetic field, enters a magnetic field at right angle, comma, it experiences a maximum magnetic force, and the locus of its path. Is a circle. Full stop. Right. This means when a charged particle enters a magnetic field region at right angle, comma, it acquires a circular path. It acquires a circular path. Please don't. This is because F is direction of force is perpendicular to both. Velocity and magnetic field B vector. Okay. Now, just try to understand this point. Okay, this is quite an important point. When a charged particle enters a magnetic field region at 0 degree or 180 degree, no force is experienced by it, it will go straight. There will be nothing happening to its path. Its path was a straight line, it will remain the same. But when it enters a magnetic field region at right angle, then its path will become circular. It will be acquiring a circular path. It will start moving in the magnetic field region in the form of a circle. It will keep on moving, revolving there in the form of a circle. That is quite a strange result. Unexpected result. Something will happen to it, it will acquire a circular path. And why does it acquire a circular path? There is a reason, because force is perpendicular to velocity and force is even perpendicular to the magnetic field. So because the direction of this force is given by Fleming's left hand rule, this is the rule. So in these three fingers, no, we have FBI. You remember this way, like CBI, FBI, CBI is for India, Central Bureau of Intelligence. FBI is for America, Federal Bureau of Intelligence. It's a shortcut to memorize this one, FBI. First finger represents force. Second finger represents magnetic field. P, F, B, B is magnetic field and I is current. Charge particle moving will form current because we know the flow of charges is called current. So these three fingers, all the three of them are perpendicular to one another. If you stretch in this manner, just have a look at it. All the three are perpendicular. F is perpendicular to B, and then B is perpendicular to what? V, you know. And all of them are perpendicular to one another this way. So one example, see in class 11 you have studied that when a body moves in a circular path, velocity at any point is given by drawing a tangent to that point, and there will be centripetal force acting on the body. What direction does the centripetal force act on the body? Towards the center. Towards the center. What observation do you have? You have the observation F and V are perpendicular to one another. Normal straight line motion time, what happened? Whichever direction the force is applied, body will move in the same direction. Direction of force and direction of velocity will be the same in straight line motion. But in a circular motion, F will be perpendicular to velocity. And here F is perpendicular to velocity and also F is perpendicular to the magnetic field. This condition is only satisfied by circular motion, when the body is having circular motion. There only it is possible, otherwise not possible. F, V and B, the field also should be perpendicular. So very often they ask this question, what is the locus of an electron which enters magnetic field region at right angle? They will say that. What is the locus? Locus means what, by its motion, what kind of path will be formed? What type of shape the path of the motion will be having? It's a circle. The locus is a circle. Due to its motion, a circle will be formed. Geometrical figure will be a circle. But again, I'll just inform you and I'll prove it also later, okay? When an electron enters an electric field, not magnetic field, electric field at right angle, then the path will become parabolic, the locus will be a parabola in that case. Magnetic field region circle, electric field region parabola. You need to read the question very very carefully, what they are talking about. Are they talking about electric field or they are talking about magnetic field? When a charged particle enters an electric field region at right angle, the path is parabola or the locus is parabola. Path is parabolic. But when it enters a magnetic field region at right angle at 90 degree, then the path is a circle. And I am going to prove that also mathematically. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So you need to differentiate between the two kinds of locus. Locus of charge particle in electric field and in magnetic field. And it is applicable for any charged particle, not applicable for any uncharged. Neutron moving in magnetic field, will it experience any force? No. Why? Because Q is zero, neutron doesn't have any charge. Neutron value of Q is zero, so FL will also be zero. So in no circumstances the uncharged particle will experience any force. This is only applicable for moving charges. That's why heading has been moving charges. The body has to be a charged body, then only this will be experienced. A proton is entering a magnetic field at right angle. What will be the locus of this path?
Circle.
Because a proton also charged particle. Electron, proton, they all alpha particle is entering a magnetic field region at right angle. Will it experience the force? Alpha particle also is charged. It contains two positive charge. So there will be beta particle entering. Beta particle is nothing but an electron. That will also be experienced. Gamma ray is entering. No, because gamma is uncharged. So we need to be very careful about it. Now write down below that continuation of this only, right? The radius of the circular path. The radius of the circular path. The radius of the circular path can be determined as follows. The radius of the circular path can be determined. Right, and since F is equal to, what is the formula? We have actually formula is Q VB sin theta, no? But theta value is 90 degrees, so sin 90 is 1. I'll just add F is equal to Q VB, yeah, no? This F will be equal to, this F will provide a centripetal force. We write it, right? Since, right here, centripetal force. Is equal to magnetic force. This is magnetic force actually. This is the formula of magnetic force at right angle. Magnetic force. This force is magnetic force, the Lorentz force. When a body acquires a circular path, no, something provides a centripetal force. If you remember class 11 or class 10, so When planets revolve around the sun, what provides a centripetal force? We say force of gravitation. Electrons revolving around the nucleus of an atom, what provides a centripetal force? We say electrostatic force between the proton and the electron will provide the necessary centripetal force. In different situation, centripetal force is provided by some other kind of forces. Here, in the path is circular, what provides a centripetal force, or what is equal to the centripetal force? We say magnetic force. So centripetal force will be equated with the magnetic force. Centripetal force formula, if you remember, is like this, mv squared by r. Class 11. You remember? Have you done class 11?
Yes, sir.
You have not done only this. Magnetic force formula is qvv. We'll cancel and make r the subject of formula. Radius and circle will come out. By following this equation, we get a value of r. Cancel 1v, will go r values coming out here, mv by uv. This is the formula of radius. Radius of the circular path. You can write here, therefore r is proportional to mv. What is mv? Mv is momentum, no? Momentum of the body, momentum of the charge particle. Radius is proportional to the momentum of the charge particle. So this is the formula of radius. Okay, now write down below that the period of revolution of the charged particle can be determined as follows. we find the period of revolution or the time period. Okay. So write it like this. We'll continue from here. Write here. R is equal to m. How to find time period? I'll give an idea of finding time period. Okay. The v value, no, in circular motion, v is equal to omega r. You remember omega? Omega formula is 2 pi by v, 2 pi upon time period. Omega is called angular velocity or angular speed or speed of rotation, we call it. So v value I put here omega by q v. You can make a note here since v is equal to omega r. Cancel r. You get omega values can be known as q v by m. Omega formula we have 2 pi by t is equal to q v by m. Therefore, making t the subject of formula, the value of t is going to be 2 pi m by q v. This is the formula of time period or period of revolution of the charge particle.
So, what is that? 2
pi by t. The time period value is coming 2 pi m by q v. Huh? Frequency and time period, how are they are related? You know the relationship between them. F is equal to 1 by t, reciprocal. The time period is this, therefore f will be equal to how much reciprocal of right on qb by 2 pi m. This is the value of frequency. This frequency is called cyclotron frequency, right on here, cyclotron frequency. Cyclotron frequency. Cyclotron frequency. F is equal to qb by 2 pi m. Just the reciprocal of time period. Cyclotron frequency. Cyclotron is in a cycle. Cycle is circle. Tron is the word coming from particularly electron. Tron is the word used for electron mainly. Electron is accelerating in the circular motion. Okay. Cyclotron. Okay. Put that as strict below nitron. A cyclotron. Cyclotron, C-Y-C-L-O-T-R-O-N. A cyclotron is a device. Is a device which is used. Which is used to accelerate. Which is used to accelerate. Which is used to accelerate a charged particle. Charged particle. Along a circular path, A cyclotron thus keeps the energy of the moving body. Keeps the energy of the moving body constant throughout its motion. Hence it is used in nuclear reactors for nuclear fission, F-I-S-S-I-O-N, nuclear fission reactions. Okay, have you understood all these derivations?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. What is a cyclotron? We have written already there. A cyclotron is a device actually. What does it do? It will accelerate the charged particle along a circular path. Thus, it keeps the body to move without losing any energy. Okay, so I just give one example here. Let us take a magnetic field, a magnetic field region will take like this. This is north, this is south pole. Magnetic field direction will be always from north to the south. Magnetic field direction will be always from north to the south. That this way the magnetic field is acting like this. A charged particle enters like this. There is a charged particle which is entering this one vertically downward. Vertically downward. Will it experience a force? Will it experience a force? Yes, charged particle I said. And as it enters the region, what will be its path expected? Will it be a straight line? Will it be a parabola or will it be a circle? What will it be? It will be a circle. It will require a circular path. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
The circular path, let us check now the direction. There is magnetic field is here, charged particle. Suppose here is the current out here. What direction does it experience a force like this? That is the center of the circle will be somewhere here. So just imagine yourself, this side is magnetic field given like this. This is magnetic field here in this situation. Here is the north pole, this is what magnetic field is doing like this. Charged particle enters like this. Center of the circle should be there. That means the charged particle will be having a circular path like this way. This way it will go out. Center is here. Center of the circle is somewhere. Okay. Understood. One second. Magnetic field region is north to the south. We can just take it this way. Like this. This side is south pole. This side is north pole of the magnet. This is your magnet. Charged particle entering in this direction, that is, this way is entering. As it enters, the rule says, Fleming left hand rule says like this. Force should act this way, no? And the force will act centripetal force towards the center of the circle. That means the center of the circle is somewhere there. That means the charged particle will be coming here and group will go like this. Center is here, center of the circle. The path will be circular. Now, this is called, this such a device is only called cyclotron. Cyclotron will be containing a bar magnet, horseshoe magnet, like this, north pole here, south pole here, and there will be a narrow beam over here. There is a narrow beam on here, this electron gun will be there. There will be a gun, you know, which will fire a charged particle. Okay. And then from here the charged particles will be entering this region and they all will be acquiring the path in this way, the circular path. This way it will keep on moving, moving, moving. What is the advantage? You know, in a circular motion, velocity, magnitude will be the same. So kinetic energy will be same, half mv square, but at all points will be the same energy it will have all the time. So it will not lose any energy. So energy remains constant throughout. So it will keep on moving without any energy. Whatever energy it enters, whatever, the same energy will remain intact. There will be no loss of energy taking place. And this becomes advantageous for nuclear fission reaction. I will just show how the nuclear fission reaction takes place. Again, you have to do in section C, okay? That is your second semester. But I am just giving a little idea only. There are two types of nuclear reaction. One is fission, one is fusion. Class 10 also you have done. What is fission? Fission is the process of breaking a heavy nucleus into two fragments by bombardment of a neutron. It breaks up into two pieces and energy is released. It makes some amount of heat energy is released. That energy is called nuclear energy. Nuclear energy is nothing but heat energy. Nuclear energy is released always in the form of heat. And that heat we can utilize. We can change this into another form, we can generate electricity by using that heat energy. So in the nuclear reactor, atomic reactor, no. We don't make only the atom bombs. We are generating electricity, electrical power we are generating there. Don't think that we are making only bombs there, atomic bombs, nuclear bombs only. No. We are generating electricity, which is very, very useful. So, to have nuclear fission reaction, a uranium nucleus is taken, uranium. Okay, uranium-235, U-235 is taken and it has to be bombarded by a neutron. normally what happens here, suppose we are having a nucleus here, uranium nucleus is here. Can we allow neutron to come here and move around like this? Neutron is uncharged, no? So cyclotron will work only for charged particle. This formula is applicable, force will be explained only by the charged particle. Then the path is circular, no? The neutron only we cannot have. In that case, what do we have? We will have this one, 1H2, this nucleus of hydrogen atom. This is called deuterium. Hydrogen has got three isotopes, 1H1, 1H2, 1H3. So deuterium is used. We are not going to ask that much detail, I am just telling you, okay? Deuterium will be sent through the gun, electron gun, okay? Fire. It will enter, what kind of path is going to acquire? It's going to acquire a circular path. So circular path, suppose this way it is acquiring like this. It is moving around the uranium escape at the center, it's moving around like this all the time. This way. And energy of this this one is same throughout. Okay. Just check on it, how many proton, how many neutron does it have? It has one proton, and how many neutron? 2 minus 1, how many neutron it has? 1. Okay. So this is the system is kept ready like this all the time. Cyclotron. And when we want reaction to take place, we'll withdraw the magnetic field. Once you remove the magnetic field, what will happen to this circular path? Now the path will become spiral, it will come closer to the center. It is same as, you know, let us take a piece of string, tie it with a stone and whirl it this way. Once you stop whirling, where does the piece of stone go? The piece of stone will be coming where? Towards the center now. Because from the center only the force is acting and the body is being pulled by the center. Once you stop giving this force, what will happen? The body will be coming where? Towards the center. So that is the whole idea. Once we withdraw this from it, once we remove it, the now the path will become spiral now like this. It will be coming towards the center like this way. Slowly. And ultimately it will come and hit the center. And at the center we got uranium nucleus. Uranium nucleus is strongly positive charged now. The proton present, positive, this proton will be repelled. But neutron will not experience any repulsive force. That neutron will come and hit the nucleus and will cause fission. How is the logic? In the beginning we are taking both proton and neutron together. Because we can't only have neutron to have a path like this. Only neutron cannot manage circular path. So we are in the beginning sending in the form of this one, 1H2, that it contains one proton and one neutron. But once we withdraw the magnetic field we are withdrawing. That means now the path becomes spiral and it will come to the center. And at the center we got uranium nucleus. Nucleus is always positive charge. No? And uranium nucleus is strongly, it contains so many, 92 protons. And this is only one proton. The 92 proton will cause this one to be repelled. So only neutron will be coming there, because neutron will not experience any repulsive force. It is uncharged. It will go and hit the nucleus, uranium nucleus, and cause fission. So what is the use of cyclotron? What is the use? Where do we use? We use in nuclear reactor, in atomic reactor, for nuclear fission purpose, for nuclear fission reactions. Understood? That is the use of cyclotron. They will not ask you this long question, but they had asked in ISC once question like this. I'll just tell you later. There was MCQ question, and that they had asked the particle which cannot be accelerated through a cyclotron is, and four options were given. The particle which cannot be accelerated through a cyclotron is. Four options were given: electron, proton, alpha particle, neutron. Which is the answer?
Neutron.
What is the reason? Give a reason. Suppose by chance they asked. Though they were not asking that, because they were MCQ. But what is the reason? Because it is uncharged. So The cyclotron is a device. Actually, cyclotron is nothing. It contains only two things: magnetic field, magnet bar, horseshoe magnet, and a gun. You know, through which the charged particle will be fired perpendicular to that area, to that region. And where do we use? Name a place where do we use cyclotron? We say an atomic reactor, nuclear reactor one, in order to have nuclear fission reactions. Done. Okay, today we just started. Tomorrow I'll show the part parabolic, and then tomorrow the chapter will be over. Chapter is not lengthy. This part is over. This topic will be over tomorrow. Okay, tomorrow we'll be doing problem.